Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Aditya Gupta. So I did my MBBS from All India Institute of Medical Sciences, AIIMS New Delhi, and did my MD in Pediatrics, following which I'm doing my DM in Pediatric Oncology from AIIMS Delhi. So in this video, I'll be talking about whether as a medical student, if you're just going to go in a medical college, or if you're in your first or second year, what's good for you? Should you buy a tablet? And which tablet? And if not, a laptop. The classic conundrum, whether you should buy a tablet or a laptop. So I have a MacBook Pro, I do have a laptop, I have an iPad also, and this is a different tablet. This is Samsung Galaxy Tab. This is the tablet of my fiance, Dr. Divya. She also makes videos. If you want to check them out, you can check the link in the description. This is a tablet which is really different from iPad. So I'll be discussing what are the advantages of having a, having a tablet, and what are the disadvantages of having a tablet, and what are the advantages of using a laptop.
So the advantages of iPad are many. I mean, you can easily keep all your books in the PDF format in an iPad. So these are the most of the books that I have with me in my iPad. Most of them are hematology books because I'm doing my DM in pediatric oncology. So I can just open up any book, read that book, use my Apple Pencil, underline that book, highlight that book or something on those lines. So you can keep all your MBBS books in an iPad. That's a very big advantage of having an iPad. And you can read those books in the PDF format as compared to a laptop. It's not that you cannot read your PDFs from laptop, but laptop is cumbersome. iPad tends to be very mobile, as you can see from this way I'm holding my iPad. And apart from that, everything is there in iPad. iPad is almost as good as a laptop. You can listen to your music, you can do your PowerPoint presentations, and at the same point of time, anything, your accounts, your YouTube music, go to Amazon Prime videos, whatever, go to Netflix. So basically, iPad is an all-in-one package that offers everything that a laptop has. There's just one small slight disadvantage of having an iPad. First, laptops in the inner range tend to be less costly. And a laptop will cost you around, a laptop will cost you something around 30,000 to 35,000, which will be mostly decent for usage. While an iPad, if you take the basic iPad, that will be 35,000. If you add a keyboard, so I do have a keyboard with me. If you add a keyboard along with a pencil, the total cost will be something around 45 to 47,000. So if you're short on money, laptop can be a better option. There's one distinct disadvantage of iPad that I really wanted to highlight. That distinct disadvantage is this one. Making presentations is a bit tough on iPad. I mean, it's not that I haven't made presentations on an iPad. I actually made this presentation on an iPad only. Having said that, it is tough to make presentation on an iPad. It's easier, much easier. It's in fact much easier to make a presentation as far as your laptop is concerned rather than your iPad. The good thing about laptop is basically this. The biggest advantage of having a laptop, I believe, is the PowerPoint. So I have a folder here of all my PowerPoints. If you are someone who reads a lot from PowerPoints, or if you have a you're in a college which has a lot of PowerPoint making, I mean, you can see the PowerPoints in tablet as well. There's no problem in that. But making PowerPoints is much easier as far as your laptop is concerned. There are other advantages of having a laptop. Laptop is obviously a full device. There's something which tablet can't do. Laptop, everything tablet can be done. But laptops are in general, heavy, less portable, and you cannot read the PDFs from laptop. That's one of the biggest disadvantages of having a laptop. Last but definitely not the least, I will talk about this thing, this Samsung Galaxy S7. So like I said, iPad can be pretty expensive in nature. Now, if you're someone who wants to have a tablet but does not have the money for an iPad, I will suggest this Samsung Galaxy Tab 7S. Now, as you can see, it's pretty smooth. It works well. This is what my fiance uses it. It has pretty much everything that an iPad has. The Jeeb lectures, YouTube music, your Adobe Acrobat. You can use it to access the files and everything. So she is reading her Nelsons and everything. So everything can be done in this tablet. This tablet, as compared to a normal tablet, this is just 25,000, and it comes with a S Pen as well. And you can make notes as well. I mean, the notes of her notes, if I show you her notes, you'll be actually surprised. She makes amazing notes actually. Yeah. So these are her notes. I mean, can you see the quality of notes that she has made? the handwritten notes that she has made of clinical approach to fever in children and everything. So note making can be done in this iPad. This is actually better in my opinion as compared to Apple iPad. As far as note making is concerned, this is a much better pencil to write from and to making notes. Having said that, Apple iPad is way more, I mean, I agree this is smooth, but iPad is much more powerful, has much more easier to use compatibility. I'm myself a sort of an Apple fanboy, so I'll say that it's better to take an Apple iPad. So depending upon your budget, depending upon your so the final virtue for final verdict me is that if you have to just go between a laptop or a tablet, I'll say go for a tablet. You can prefer to take a laptop if your college requires you to make a lot of PowerPoint presentations, because making a PowerPoint presentation in a tablet is a bit of a hassle. Second thing, as far as tablet is concerned, my heart goes for an Apple iPad. Buy a 128GB because that will be suffice for most of your work, along with a pencil and a keyboard. Having said that, if you are someone who cannot afford an Apple iPad, Samsung Galaxy Tab is a good alternative. My fiance uses it and I absolutely love that material, and it's excellent for note taking. There's one area where it actually beats Apple iPad. So this is all my review as far as your Apple iPad versus tablet is concerned. I hope you Apple iPad versus laptop is concerned. I hope you liked it. If you like my videos, do like, share, comment, and let me know what further video should I make. Thank you and have a nice day.